Before, sorry, before and after.
Okay, this is before.
Yeah.
After.
Very subtle. Very subtle. But what happens now? Shall we before again?
Okay.
Boom. See, what we do now is now you see the room more. Put it in.
Put it in.
Now we look at him.
Focus on him.
That's how subtle it is. And with this subtleties we work. Now bring the outside a little, bring the bring it a little bit closer in. Show the vignette.
Okay.
Show it.
Okay.
That's really show the circle. There yeah. See, that's what he did. Now what you can do is bring the outside a little bit more out so that he can make it softer. You have to do more softer. So now only this is still well exposed to me, and make the outside a little darker.
Make outside a little bit darker?
Yeah.
Okay. You mean only here? Or
no. Overall, yeah, the outside overall.
Okay,
sorry.
Overall outside.
See, he gets rid of the thing, and now we see it happening. Now, you see, this is pretty good. So it doesn't bother me that it is a little darker up there. It doesn't bother me that this little... But now we look at him with the candles. That's the subtlety, that's a subtle difference. Mm-hmm. And so, no producer between us, that doesn't go out, no producer, no studio wants this. Because they don't want to make it darker. So what I do is when I start a session of color correction, I put in the vignette and tell the timer never to talk about it. And to the whole productions, leave it in there. And if I'm correcting and I find it is too strong, then I take it out. But I create, in fact, for the projection, a kind of a tunnel vision that creates already over the whole production a kind of feeling of concentrating on the main part of the image. And that is very helpful. That's a secret I give you there.
But once when we on the screen,
yeah,
it will be another view.
No. The digital screen, a real digit, in this case because of the back projection, but the front projection digital is very flat. So that's why I bring it in, what we have over the last 100 years almost of projection, where that visual, the tunnel vision helps us to be more into what you see, concentrate on what you on the story and on what you want to see, give you a little bit more emotional connection. And that's very subtle, and all the things, all the little things together create that extra and of storytelling. No. Now we go to the next step.
Okay.
Follow it. The same shot. This is 5,000 still?
Sorry?
This is 5,000, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Okay. 5, now we're going to denoise a little bit. We see that it's a little bit, because we have not... You have to be very careful with it. Because I think it looks good. It doesn't look 100% sharp, but it's always because it's just an image, just a separate image.
Yep. So do you want it a little bit more?
First, you can zoom in, right? First, zoom in to a big, real big.
Okay. On the face?
Yeah. You look how much he zooms in. Now we see noise, right? Mm-hmm. Quite a lot.
Yep.
Now leave this for a second. Okay. It's not focused. Why is it not focused?
Sorry.
Because it's that zoom.
There's a ready effect. The denoising is there, but...
So no, he didn't do the noise yet. He didn't denoise yet.
A little bit, just a little bit.
Okay, you take it out for a second.
Okay, out ready.
Yeah.
This is a default.
Yeah, okay. So, no, it's just a 1.9 lens enlarged so much. And okay, now denoise it a little more. No, it's not denoise, right?
Okay.
Denoise it.
Okay. Okay, so this default. 2%?
More.
More? Like that?
And go back and forth between the two?
Zoom out?
No. In and out.
In and out? Okay.
Show me with and without, that's what I mean. Not zoom in.
I see, yeah. Okay. In and before, after.
Yeah, before, after. That's, I see. That's the right
thing. Okay, so this is before.
Yeah.
This is after.
More, you need to get more.
A little bit more?
Yeah.
Okay.
So that you...
Something like that.
Yeah.
Okay, before, after.
Still can go a little bit more.
A little bit more? Okay.
Okay.
Before, after.
Do it again.
Okay, before.
Go more. That I want to show that it is.
Okay.
Go further. 100% more.
Further.
Yeah, there. Do this.
There
and
go.
Show me.
Extreme. Okay. The before, after.
Wish.
Yeah.
No flash, please.
Before, after.
Yeah, that's better. Go even further. See, what I do is I try to denoise so that the mid tones, now it's too much.
Yeah.
Now it starts to defocus. Mm-hmm. So denoising means in fact also defocusing. If you do it a lot, do it extreme for a second, go even much further. Okay. See, this is denoising. So we don't see the noise anymore, but also your whole focus is gone. So it's a very fine line, denoising. Denoising is not, it's always bad, in fact. But you have to bring it to the level that that you don't see it as bad. So go back now to what we decided.
Okay.
See, this is still focus. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Now let's go. Now show me the 4,000 now. To
4,000.
In comparison with this.
This one.
See, this is 4,000, blown up from 800. That is pretty shocking, right?
Mm-hmm. Why 5,000 is better?
And this is only 4,000. And this, show me again, the other one.
5,000.
This is 5,000. So this is more sensitive. So now you see the difference between the 800 setting and the 5,000. What we don't see is how 800 would look like this. So that's what I would like to do later, to make it shots exactly the same. 800 ASA and then, sorry, with ND filter, make the same shot on 5000 ASA and do the same here in this setup. Okay.